Hi, everybody. Oh my gosh, thank you so much for joining me today for my session here with this amazing conference. I hope you've been enjoying everybody else's talks. I know I have. I've been learning so much. And yes, I'm pre-recording this, but I just already know it's amazing. So I'm confident in saying that statement. I'm so, so glad to have you here today. I can't wait to hear your questions. We're going to have a really fun conversation. I think it's going to get your brain wheels turning. At least I hope so. And if you have any questions, you can always contact me on LinkedIn and Twitter. I love to have conversations with everyone and talk shop. I'm such a nerd, so please feel free to reach out. So today we're going to be talking about social media community building and how to use your existing data to connect with your audience. So let's get started. So our agenda today is following a traditional who, what, where, when, why, and we're going to deep dive into how to get to know our audience, how to use that information to create amazing social content, and why we should be putting in the work. So I am Diana Richardson. I have been a digital marketer since 2006, and yes, I answered an ad in the paper, and that started my long journey into digital marketing. I learned SEO and PPC from the ground up with a variety of different clients, and as my career has progressed, I moved into social media, which also I have worked with many different shapes and sizes of clients with many different types of audiences, and it's been a lot of fun. And now here at SEMrush, I get to do both. So I get to talk about SEO and I get to work on social media, and it's the greatest gig ever. So we're going to talk about, well, we're just going to get right into it. And we're going to talk about why data is so important. So data is the result of actual people interacting with your website and your social media. And you want to use that as digital marketers to create more and more content, because assumptions or what we think might be interesting is not based on data. Our data is based on real people, and that should be the foundation for engaging content. I mean, why not? We're armed with the information already. You can also do yourself a favor and create audience profiles based on this data. It's actually a great way to keep different marketing teams or different marketers on your team aligned and on the same page about who your audience actually is and what they're interested in, and that benefits more people than you think, even sales. So what does the actual data tell us? It tells us some really interesting information about the people interested in us, right? So it tells us the basics: age, gender, and location. But it's amazing because it actually will tell us things like their location and their hobbies, their career paths and consumer habits, and all sorts of nitty-gritty details so we can get to know them as people. So the data sources we're going to walk through real quick before I show you how to use this information for your social media, we're going to show you how you can find data in Google Analytics, Facebook Insights, and then SEMrush's own Market Explorer. You don't have to use Google Analytics specifically, but that's going to be the screenshots I use and the examples I use today. If you're using another software, just be sure to ask them where you can find this kind of information. But Google Analytics does a great job, so that's what we're going to use. So starting right out of the gate, we get our basic demographics, our age and our gender. So make sure you make some notes about that. You're also able to deep dive a little bit and see in our age groups who's engaging more with the website, who's staying on longer, who's converting, and that could help you whittle down which age groups maybe to focus on for your digital content. Same thing with gender: your products or services or website information may gear towards one or the other. So here you're able to see if that strategy is working. You're also able to get some really great geographic information. And this is important if you're working with things like regional terminology, if you're dealing with slang, if you want to be more a natural speaker, you want to make sure that the target country or the country that you're targeting is actually interacting with your website. And if you're seeing a country, or even you can get deeper than just the country level, you can understand cities and states and metro areas, that you, it arms you with the ability to research colloquial terms and more, even especially if you're not from that area, it helps you communicate in their language as you're creating content and creative. So what's really interesting in Google Analytics, and this is just my absolute piece of information from Google Analytics, are the audience categories, and there are three. So you have your affinity categories, and don't worry, we're going to go deep into what this actually looks like. But affinity is the broad picture of your users' lifestyles, hobbies, and habits. And then in-market is a sneak peek into what are they actively researching and comparing, what are they in the market for. And then the other, which is not so well named, but actually is very interesting, is and it's actually the most specific view of your audience that you're going to get through Google Analytics. So if we're dealing with these affinity interest categories, we're talking broad picture here of the people using our website, the people interested in doing business with us, we get to see their broad interests like hobbies. So for example, we can understand that they are broadly interested in games, but we don't know necessarily yet if that means board games, video games, we'll get there. We can also find things like their lifestyles. So yay, they love pets. So they probably have a cat or a dog or a bird or a pig or something at home. So that's really interesting to know. And then we also get to understand important habits. So here we get to see that these people in particular are value shoppers. So that's a great piece of information to be armed with as the marketers, because things like promo codes will resonate very, very strongly with these people that we're trying to connect with. The in-market audience is, again, showing us what our people are actively researching and comparing and in the market for. So this particular audience, which is not Semrush's audience, by the way, this is just arbitrary data, but this particular audience is interested and actively seeking out residential real estate for sale. That's huge to know and something to be cognizant of as a digital marketer. So again, they're in the market for a new home. And then finally, our randomly named other category is going to give us very specific views of our audience. So now we saw in our affinity market that they were interested in games, but here in the other category, we can see specifically they are really interested in role-playing games, which is fascinating. We can also specifically see that they are interested in anime, and another specific insight into these people that we're studying is that they're interested in pop music. So this just is such a great piece of detail for you to know about your audience and as you're choosing and creating content. So I hope you're taking notes as you're going through the data about your audience. I hope you're taking notes about who they are and what they're interested in, because that's going to pay off in the end. So switching to Facebook Insights here again, we're going to be able to see our basic demographics right out of the gate, age and gender, make sure it matches with Google Analytics. And if it does not, that's okay. It might just be an indicator that you need to create a separate profile or audience profile or persona for this particular audience sect. It also, again, gives us great breakdowns of where they are geographically located, so we can kind of start to use their terminology and speak like them when we're creating social media content. But here's the best part about Facebook Insights. We get to see what our audience is interested in outside of us. And that's huge because we're dealing with human beings, right? We have naturally are interested in multiple things, lots of brands. So we get to get that little sneak peek here in the Facebook Insights. Here's your pro tip right out of here. You as the marketer, you as a social media marketer, the digital marketer, follow these brands on social media. This will not only put you in your audience's shoes so you can interact with them as if you are your audience, but it also gives you, the marketer, content inspiration. Now, don't steal anybody's most amazing post, but you get to see what your audience is interacting with and engaging with, and will help you on your art direction for your creative. So again, I hope you're taking even more notes about what your people are interested in throughout social media and Facebook. So the last data source we're going to look through is Semrush's own Market Explorer. And this tool is really great for the exercise we're doing now, but it's also super amazing if you have a new client or a new industry that you want to explore. You want to find out the lay of the land. This is the tool for you. So right out, we're also getting our basic demographics. Again, make sure it's lining up with Google Analytics and Facebook. But we get some fabulous insights into hobbies, lifestyle, and personality. So we can see here that the audience that we're looking at is interested in not only technology and technical aspects, but they love them some food. So this gives us a lot of great detail about our fun audience. This is my favorite part. This is really super cool. So here with using the Market Explorer tool, we get to answer the question that we all have asked ourselves, where do I even start on social media? Well, this gives you a breakdown as to where the audience is a lot. So here you would start with Facebook and then maybe move into Pinterest and Instagram, which is an amazing, great strategic place to start. But here's your second pro tip. This also gives you insight into what types of media and content this audience really, really likes. So number two is YouTube. So we get to understand that this audience really loves watching maybe longer form videos on YouTube. So hint, hint for you, the social media manager, that that's something to take into consideration when you're creating your content. Okay. So, what have we learned about our audience? Well, we've learned a lot about their lifestyle. We've learned about their hobbies, how they shop, their social media preferences, who else they're following on social media, and where they are in their life. So, we've gotten to know them as people. And I love that because that is what marketing should absolutely be about, is getting to know people for being human, and not just somebody for us to pitch to. So yes, absolutely, we've gotten to know these people on a very personal level just through data. So how the heck does this help you, digital marketer? Well, it helps you in several different ways. It helps you in the form of content creation. So this is going to be such, your brain is going to explode with topic ideas. So for example, as we were showing you through Google Analytics, we got to see that this audience was really into residential real estate. So write some content about residential real estate because you already know your audience is interested in it. It's also going to help you understand the issues and the questions that your audience are facing and what you should be answering. So answer some of these important questions throughout your website content and in your social media content. So here is the example that this audience is going through an employment phase here, which can be really stressful and really unknown. So maybe you could write a tweet or something or a LinkedIn post, maybe a little bit of a lengthy LinkedIn post that can help somebody with a phase of the employment process. It's also going to give you clues as to what type of content to produce. How-tos, lists, reviews, etc. are going to be, you're going to be able to determine what kind of content you even need to produce based on their interests. So, for example, here around the hotel and accommodation interest for our audience, it would be amazing if you could create a social media checklist of what you should pack the first time you're visiting a country outside of yours. Hello, how amazing would that be? That's going to get all of the attention. You would be so great if you could help me with that. So again, you can get clues from your audience interests in that way. It's also going to lead you to develop really fun content like memes, GIFs, polls, and things that are interactive. So think viral here. So in the beauty and personal care, you can have a lot of fun with polls and brands and funny GIFs and memes. All about hair care, beauty fails, and things around that nature, and just have fun with it. And data. People love to consume data. They love statistical insights on, for all sorts of things. So if your audience is into the automotive industry, for example, maybe you could create some interesting data or interesting content around what to expect for new vehicles for 2022. All right, it's also going to help you choose your visuals. This is your art direction piece. So this you want to choose images that your audience can relate to. So if you see that their lifestyle is around their pets, maybe you could choose visuals that have puppies and kittens and birds and pigs and something that they might have at home because they are going to really respond to that sort of visual. You also want to choose visuals where they can see themselves, of course. So if you have something really unique in your audience description, like being a fan of something, you can really play up what it means and what it looks like to be a fan of something. You know, all decked out in the gear, cosplay, things like that could really help their audience see themselves in association with you and your brand. You also want to choose visuals that will demonstrate where your audience wants to be. So for example, they're thinking about dinner, and they're checking out for the day. They want to be prepping for dinner. So for example, if you've got an audience that's really like craving fast food, you could choose visuals around burgers or pizza or something like that, or picking up at a restaurant and having a to-go order. And that's where they can really see themselves relating to you. But then of course, you also want to choose visuals of where your audience wishes they were, or wishes what something they wish they were doing instead of what they were currently doing. So if they have an interest around gaming, you could choose visuals around someone coming home from work and queuing up their computer, queuing up their game system, and having a break from the day and getting into their game. So the last way this is going to inspire you and allow you to explore your audience more is through participation. You want to be active in this community. So you could do fun things like researching hashtags. So Target, for example, is a brand that our audience is clearly very interested in. So you could research hashtags around Target. Let's say Halloween is coming up, which it is. Maybe Target has a Halloween hashtag you can join in on as part of your branding and get kind of a little cross promotional exposure there that's on theme but engaging with a different audience. You can join Facebook and LinkedIn groups related to the topics, again, that your audience is interested in. So here we see that they are also interested in the brand Tasty, which is a food recipe cooking brand. And so maybe you join Facebook and LinkedIn groups around really interesting recipes or food hacks and things like that. So you can, again, be participating on behalf of your brand with an audience that already likes you, but now connects you in a different way. This is a really fun one, responding to brands that are unrelated to your industry. So we can see here that our audience engages and likes Walmart. So maybe you are not a retail brand. Maybe you're something else. Maybe you're a restaurant. Maybe you're a car dealership. Maybe you're a dentist. So you don't really have a connection to Walmart. But you could do a really fun tweet, per se, that engages with Walmart and relates back to you. We've had a lot of fun with this here at SEMrush, and it's gone really, really well for us. So get creative, think outside the box, and engage with other brands outside of your industry. And also ask questions. Ask questions about brands and people. Here, for example, M&M. Ask your audience questions on these topics to get them thinking about something else, right? To get them to associate you with something more than just who you are, that you, the brand, and then the audience have more in common than just you, the brand. If you take away one thing today from this session, I want it to be this. Let everything you do be a conversation starter. And follow up with that conversation. Don't ask the question and not follow up with the answers, but be the conversation starter, whether it's with people individually or with other brands that you're engaging with. So why even try this? Why put in the work for something to do all of this? Because it works. And we at SEMrush have had a lot of fun putting all of these strategies into place, starting conversations, engaging with our audience, engaging with brands, and just bringing more people into our community based on what they are interested in. It's been really, really fun. The point is that you're able to use your data to create conversation starters, to build this community, and really connect with your existing audience and a new audience on a way that's not just superficial, on a way that's not just brand and consumer, on a way that really does connect you as people, as you as the digital marketer, you as the social media marketer are connecting to other people. So just keep that in mind as you're using this data and getting to know these people and in the content that you create. So like I said in the beginning, please feel free to reach out to me on Twitter and LinkedIn. I love to talk shop. I love to talk to people, if that's not obvious. So please feel free to reach out to me. Let me know how you discovered me. And let's just talk, especially if you have any questions. I know we're going to answer questions here in a few minutes. So let's keep the conversation going. I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you again for being here.